Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, how are you? I hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. I'm also fine by the grace of Almighty Allah the Exalted. In this class, we shall talk about Nifaq. Yes. We shall be able to know what is Nifaq or the acquaintance of Nifaq and what is this consequence. First of all, I'd like to thank Allah the Exalted who has given us the opportunity once again after passing a year. Long time, which was assuming unending. I mean, the year was not passing. It was too hard to pass the time. That's why we were disheartened and we felt very sorry. Ultimately, Allah the Exalted has picked up from our sorrowful life, and this is another year, and we hope, we are optimistic that Allah the Exalted will clear the conundrums, the disorders from our country as well as from the whole world. So boys, the students of class 10, today, the topic which we have chosen to discuss, that is Nifaq. Nifaq is an Arabic word, you know. And as per you have learned in class 8, 9 about Nifaq, so I think it's not necessary to describe it elaborately. Even though I have given here some words to know its literal or verbal meaning. Here we can see a diagram. The literal or verbative meaning of Nifaq is given here. First of all, false appearance. What does Nifaq mean? If you write down false appearance in a single word. Yes, false appearance. Please write down. What does Nifaq mean? False appearance. Yeah. Now, hypocrisy, duplicity, then deceit, and ultimately fraud. This is all about the verbative meaning or literal meaning that's given in your text. But if we talk about the first one, false appearance, that is enough. Each and every step of our life, if we look clearly, or if we look with our inner sight, then we will see many things, also many different things. So those different things sometimes become also from false appearance, and we have to trace out those false appearance, and we need to avoid those false appearance also by ourselves. Here, our dear Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam described the sign of munafiq. I mean, munafiq is who? Who is munafiq? The person who commits nifaq is called munafiq. Very simply, the person who commits nifaq or the person who performs nifaq is called munafiq. Clear? So also you can write down this one. On the other hand, if we give an example of munafiq or nifaq or the meaning of nifaq, suppose we are not too many good people, or some people are intended to demonstrate themselves as a good, as a best, but they are not good at all, they are bad or worst. But they are very much prompted to prove themselves as a good, as a best. That is hypocrisy, that is nifaq. They are not saint at all, but they are pretending to be saint. They are not, you know, very honest, but they are pretending to be honest. They are not truthful, but they are pretending to be very truthful. That is nifaq. And those people are termed as munafiq, because false appearance, I have mentioned prior to this, and we have learned false appearance, one of the prominent meanings of the word nifaq, right? Now come to the point. What did Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say in this regard in hadith? I mean, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given us the acquaintance through which we can trace out the munafiq, or we can recognize the munafiq. Okay. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in hadith, ayatul munafiqi salas. Ayatul munafiqi, I mean sign of munafiq. Sign of munafiq, salas, I mean three. I have given here on the board. Please look at the board and write down. Ayatul munafiq is salas. Sign of munafiq are three. First one is, iza haddatha kadaba. Whenever he speaks, he or she speaks, tells a lie. Tells a lie. One side. Number one. Number two, وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفَ. Whenever he promises, he or she promises, breaks the promise. Sign of munafiq. Sign of munafiq. Yes. وَإِذَا وَأُتُمِنَ خَان. Number three, I have given the number in Arabic. As per it is Arabic, so I have given number. You can write down in English also. And if you choose it, then you can write down Arabic also. Okay. Waiza utumina khon or waiza utumina khon. And whenever something is kept in his custody, he or she grabs it. So these all three about the sign or symptoms of munafiq. And according to the hadith, we have come to know these three signs. The boys or the students in Sahih Bukhari, we can get this hadith, or this hadith belongs to Sahih al-Bukhari. So please write down the information also. Bad effects or the consequence or the aftermath of munafiq is narrated here by Allah the Exalted? Let's know, or please write down also. Allahu yashhadu innal munafiqina lakadibun. Allah the Exalted says or proclaimed in his holy Quran very clearly, Allahu yashhadu innal munafiqina lakadibun. Yes. Idha haddatha kadaba. Number one from hadith. Now you can match with hadith and Quran, Quranic verse and hadith. Okay, it's matching directly, right? And it's very clear and conspicuous before us. Now, Allah yashhadu innal munafiqina lakadibun. Where does this verse belong? This verse belong to Surah Al-Munafiqun and verse number 1. Please write down. And ultimately, it is given the acquaintance of Munafiq by Allah the Exalted, and Allah the Exalted has given also the consequence of Munafiq or the result of Munafiq by telling this verse. Innal munafiqina fid darkil asfali minan nar. You have learned this verse in class 8. Also in class 9, and as per you are the students of class 10, so you are learning once again this verse. So I think you should write down this verse for a couple of times so that you can write down on your exam script when it comes in your exam. Please write down, don't forget to write down. Okay, and don't be lazy in this regard, right? If you become lazy in writing Arabic, then you won't be able to write Arabic at all. Okay, so please don't be lazy. Innal munafiqina fid darkil asfali minan nar. It means surely the hypocrites will be remain in the lowest zone or lowest layer of hell. This is the ayat which belongs to Surah An-Nisa and verse number 145. Surely the munafiq will remain in the lowest layer of hell. This verse belongs to Surah An-Nisa and verse number 145. I think you could understand the nifaq, munafiq and their consequences. In the next class, we shall come once again with the next topic. Till then, remain well all. Thanks a lot for joining this class.